Hey, what's up, everyone, and welcome back to another episode. Today, we're talking about my better supporting method. And I know you're probably all going, oh, yeah, we heard this from a bunch of other dudes before. What are you doing so different? Well, I talked about it briefly in one of my other videos, and I'll go into a bit more detail here. We've got a 12-minute video on this one, so I've got a bit of time to explain it to you while I'm doing the support work on this using that particular style. Now, the pieces I'm supporting here, I'll give the model credit, goes to Crippled God Foundry, and normally they give us some pretty nice pre-supported files. I just chose to use one of their files because I like to use a complex file for these demonstrations so we can kind of go over, honestly, how this would work on a really complex model. Now, my better supporting method, as I've referred to it, is essentially using a combination of my light support tips and my medium support tips, and mostly light support tips, and using a combination of those to come up with a perfect ratio of supports that are going to be super light, super easy to remove, not cause very much damage or, as we call pockmarks or dimples in the actual model. That should be very far and few between. So you're going to have a really nice print. Like in the example here with the base, I'm doing a majority of lights here with a few mediums peppered into the middle just for some anchoring. And this is going to print great, nice and flat. It's going to have a nice flat bottom and it'll look good when it's done. And you can use a variety. I mean, you could go in there and use a couple heavies, you could put a couple mediums, and you could vary into the size and the tip and the length and all this and that and the other. And honestly, I found that doing all of that isn't really necessary. I use this pretty much the same size supports on my models now around the board. The people who buy the models from us on our shop seem to think that the quality's good. So I don't have too many complaints there. Plus, our material is really easy to finish, so any minor defects or sanding that needs to be done is pretty easy to do on the particular material that we're printing with. So that's usually not an issue. What we do in this particular support method is we're using the tip diameter of a 0.22 millimeter. The bar diameter is a 1.22 millimeter. And the tip length on those are 3.25. And you can actually adjust that to 3.22 if you're looking to adjust it a little bit. And you can adjust between 3.20 and 3.25. Don't really want to go too much further than that. That's actually a decent length for the type of support I'm using. The medium support tips are 0.44 millimeter with a 3.44 tip length and a 1.44 bar diameter. Now, there is also a sub-medium, which I use, which is 1.33 millimeter, 3.33 millimeter tip length, and a 1.33 millimeter diameter bar. And there's also super or feather lights that I do not use much unless I'm just working on something incredibly small. Feather light supports are good for really small pieces, very small miniatures, or just tiny, 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 tiny details that you don't want any damage coming to whatsoever. But just keep in mind with a support that thin, which is a tip diameter, my feather lights I use, well, I can go all the way down to a 0.10, has a very high chance of popping off. Not a lot of material touching the model, so you have a very good chance of it not being able to hold on to the model because of that. So depending on the weight, the mass, the shift, the way it's going to pull, you're going to want to consider, okay, well, at this angle, I should probably use a slightly higher medium, or at this angle, I should use a slightly higher light, etc. But on these models where we're doing the majority of them are hollowed in the middle, and then, or in this particular case, this guy, isn't hollowed, but for the larger models where we do hollows, I'll use a majority of lights with a couple mediums as anchors. For the ones that they're solid and they're not hollowed out, like this particular one, I'm going to use a couple heavy anchors, or not heavy anchors, but the higher medium anchors. Whereas on the hollow ones, I'll probably use my sub-medium anchors because I won't necessarily need as much weight support pull back against the FEP and the VAT. Essentially, you want to be able to win that tug of war every time, and these supports will do it. but they need to be laid out in such a way that you're supporting the balance of the entire model, which also means, unfortunately, the painstaking process of going layer by layer and making sure that you actually assign enough supports in different areas to accumulate and pull back some of that pressure that they're going to be getting from the FEP when the pullback happens with your build plate going up and down in your vat. So some people forget this. There's a lot of gravity, literally gravity, that's pulling back against the build. So you have that's snapping back. So these supports need to be able to pull each part of the model back out of the vat or back away from the FEP without them snapping off. And since we're using a lot of lights and not a whole lot of mediums or anything too heavy, you have to maintain a consistency as far as using the pressure zones. And this is really where we come back to that yellow zones again. Now, the yellow areas on the model are going to indicate anything that's greater than a 45 degree angle, and anything that is pretty much an essentially a good spot to hook on a support. And I know I spoke about not using too many mini supports, but because he's got some finer details, I don't want to actually ruin some. So I'm going to use some mini supports strapped on to some of my mediums and lights in here just to try to use a little bit of lighter discretion on some of this, because this guy's got some wicked details and I really don't want to hurt any of them on this particular one. So this, I'm trying to be careful and delicate around the spots that I feel like are going to be needed to be preserved the most. And in this case, there's bits of his armor there that has some etching on it. You've got some filigree there on the back of the pauldrons. The hammer itself has got a lot of detail in there, but I don't have much of a choice. There were actually some islands in there. As you saw, we started this after I did the island supporting, only for the fact that, honestly, we've gone over island supporting a bunch of times. I didn't need to waste your time with that one. So, you know, we didn't want to start this from the beginning. But anyways, you're seeing this process as I'm going through here, and I know this is a quick and dirty process on this particular video, which, by the way, we are thinking of doing a Patreon channel where we do extended videos. And we're thinking of pricing it incredibly low, like $1 a month would get you access. And you'll get access to a lot longer videos that have longer tutorials, in-depth explanations of different types of theory and 3D printing styles that we like to go with. And we'll also probably include a private Discord server with that as well, so you guys would have access to ask me personal questions. And all that would be included with that, the Patreon. So we're thinking about going on onto a Patreon type of thing where we offer more teaching. Of course, the YouTube channel is going to stay. We have no intention of getting rid of the channel, but we do want to kind of increase what we do. And we don't necessarily think that YouTube is going to be the best place for us to do long, super long format videos. Tell us what you guys think in the comments section. Would you guys like to see something like that, like longer format videos where we actually do full-on lessons and tutorials? And, you know, we could, like I said, open up a Discord channel where we have some chat there, engage with you guys, and y'all tell us what it is that you want to see most. If that's something you guys would like to see, definitely drop us a comment, and we love to hear the feedback. Anyway, as we continue there with the fingertips, you'll notice I am using some minis to help the fingertips and not to snap them off. This guy is still pretty small on the scale size. It's only about 48, I think maybe 50. No, he's probably less than 50 millimeters tall total. And so those fingers are going to be small. So we really need to make sure we don't break them off. And applying too much support to them is just going to make it too difficult. And I don't want to over-support the hand and cause damage on the hand. So I'm being dainty with some of these parts. And I know we talked about, you know, not using too many mini supports because they get stringy or they kind of bow with some of the different resins that we use. In this particular case, I'm going to force myself to kind of do it only because of the fact that I feel that the details just really need to be preserved there. So that's important to consider too. When you do need to use them, they have their place. But I think that some of the supporting styles I've seen use far too many miniature supports, and the model literally looks like it's covered in tiny little plastic hairs. When you're cleaning it up, and it just takes a far longer time than it needs to clean up the model after you're done with all these little tiny stringy bits. So it's kind of annoying in that sense. I don't like cleaning those up. I actually prefer just having bigger supports where I can just snap them all off and be done with it. And honestly, that's my preferred method of doing it. So, as you can see, he's pretty much supported. The base is pretty much supported. We will go and do a layer by layer check, and I'm just going to kind of do like a quick check by eye. I will go back and do this layer by layer myself before I do run some of the test prints, and I will let you guys know in the comments in a couple days how those did come out once we have a chance to print out the pieces using this supporting method versus the way they were pre-supported. We can even do some comparisons if I get a chance to take some pictures of both pieces and print them out. So we'll see how all that goes, and we'll let you guys know. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching. Please hit that subscribe, like, and please leave us some comments and let us know what you think about the videos, what you want to see coming up. We'd love to hear all the feedback. Thanks, guys. See you soon.